So let me show you my project, which is a universal application for displaying data from custom-made measuring devices. So for example, in this photo, there is some microcontroller, which is using its analog-to-digital converters to read values on some input pins. So it's acting as an oscilloscope. It's sending the measured data via USB virtual com port to the computer. On the computer, my application is running and it's showing the data in the plot. The application is made to be as versatile as possible. So it supports various types of instruments. So one example would be oscilloscope, but it can also be like logging some measured data, which is changing over longer period of time. And it can also display like logic signals. It has many additional features for processing the data. So it has FFT, it has some filtering, interpolation, it can do measurements of frequency, amplitude, RMS. Basically, it has all features that you would expect on an oscilloscope. And the main reason why I made this application was to provide some reusable tools for students who are developing such devices. Because in past, there was many projects regarding creating software-defined instruments using microcontrollers. But all those projects, they used their own application to show the data and to control the device. And it's quite inefficient to make separate application for each of these projects. So my aim was to create a universal tool that can be reused. And for this, it has to be simple to use. It has to be simple to implement on the device. And basically, the concept of the application can be separated into two parts. It's the plotting part and some control interface. So the plot, it's essentially one-way communication. The device will transmit its data. They will be received by the application and plotted. The communication protocol is designed to be very universal, very simple to implement. Basically, you can decide whether you send the data as string or in binary. For example, if you on the microcontroller have a buffer which just contains raw data from the ADC, you can just send this raw data and in header of this message specify how many bits per value and what's the reference voltage, and the application will recalculate it to voltage. But in this presentation, I would like to mainly focus on the control interface, because that's actually much more difficult to make it universal. Like, how would you make universal user interface? Like, the simplest way is to just make some message console and send text commands, but that's not user-friendly. You would want to make some graphical interface to control the device. But graphical interface, it has to be made specifically for the application, specifically for the device that you are using. So how to make it universal so that you can use it with your own device by your own design. So let's start by something simple. So instead of a simple message console, I implemented kind of terminal which can accept the ANSI escape sequences. Add some additional features. So for example, when you want to have some changing value in the terminal, you can just move the text cursor back to the beginning of the line and rewrite it. Move it back, rewrite it. So that's improvement. If you just have console that is printing the input, you would have to create a new line for each new data. Here you can just change the value in place. And it also enables you to use card background and card font. So it's kind of pseudo graphical interface. But it's only displaying the output. It still doesn't provide any way of controlling apart from sending text commands. So I added one very simple but quite powerful feature. And this feature is that when user clicks on some character in the terminal, this character will be transmitted to the serial port. And the device will receive it and use it as some command. Also, this can be restricted only to characters that have colored background. Basically, this allows you to create kind of button in the terminal. So you print some character, for example, minus or plus, you make it colored background, and then user can click it. And after each click, this plus or minus will be transmitted to the device, and it could parse it as a command to increase or decrease some value. Of course, you are limited to only one character per each command, so you have to improvise a bit. But for example, you can see this example in the picture. So for example, this selection of values, it's done in such a way that each of these white fields, it contains some letters, it's A, B, C, and so on, but these letters are the same color as the background, so they are not visible. So these tricks can be used to make something that kind of resembles real graphical user interface, and it's entirely determined by the input that your device sends to this application. So the content of the terminal is independent of the application itself. But we can do even better, because my application is made in Qt framework, which is framework that uses C++, but with additional features to create graphical interface. And one of very powerful features of Qt framework is the QML language, which is programming language that allows you to describe a user interface. And this code can be loaded on runtime. So basically, when you create such a code that creates some graphical interface, the application can load it on runtime. And it has one very powerful thing called property binding. Property is essentially a variable that can be used in the code. So for example, here I defined variable named text variable, which is used in this text element and printed here. At the property binding, it means that whenever the property changes, all elements that are using this property will be updated automatically. So if this variable is modified, the text will automatically update. And I added some backend functions that allows to set these variables using commands from the microcontroller. And also method that can send something from this terminal to the microcontroller. So for example, here is some field where number can be inputted. And when the value is changed, it will send some command. And this command is determined by the QML code. So now I will show you practical example. So here I have some prototype board which contains microcontroller and some sensors. It's barometric pressure sensor and inertial motion unit. And I want to use my application to display some testing and debugging data. So when I start the application, it contains some default interface. This is basically message console and some input line. But the device firmware, it contains like byte array, which in it contains the QML code, which defines a custom interface. So after the device is connected, the custom interface gets loaded. So for example, here it draws some roll and pitch indicator. Here it shows numerical values of these. Here is some input field where user can edit the sea level pressure. And here is console for messages. This all thing is defined in the QML code, which is stored on the microcontroller, and it's sent to the application after connection. It has about 1.5 kilobyte, and it's stored in the flash memory because it's constant. And on the runtime, the microcontroller will only send message to modify values of variables that are used for the drawing. So it will send new value of roll, new value of page. And based on this, the GUI will update, because the QML code is written in such a way that the look of this indication depends on these variables. And also it prints some debug messages in this field, and it's at points to the plot. So I think this is very powerful feature, because you can define your entirely custom GUI. You will only send it once after the connection, and then you can modify the displayed values based on simple messages that are sent periodically. And also, when you modify this value, you can determine by yourself in your QML code in which format they will be transmitted to your device. So, thank you for your attention. I hope you find this interesting. If yes, then you can find the application on the GitHub repository. The application is called DataPlotter. Also, you can have a look at embedded server, which contains some firmwares of oscilloscopes based on STM32 microcontrollers and Raspberry Pi Pico, which are using my application to display the data.
Thank you for your presentation. Related to UGUI, Universal Graphical User Interface. And now there is space for some questions. So if you have questions, feel free to ask Mr. Maier. It seems that your presentation was clear for all hosts here. So thank you again.